وأقول في القرآن ما جاءت به آياته فهو الكريم المنزال وأقول قال الله جل جلاله والمصطفى الهادي ولا أتأول.
A questioner asked, I met a brother online and felt like I wanted to marry him. I tried to introduce him to my parents, but my father has turned down everyone I have suggested. I traveled to his home country and got married to him. We've now been married for a year, and I'm starting to question whether my marriage is valid.
Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen, lahu alhamdul hasan wa thana'u al-jameel, wa ashadu an la ilaha illallah wahdahu la sharika lah, yaqulu al-haqqa wa huwa yahdi al-sabeel. وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه والتابعين لهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين أما بعد. In response to your question that the sister asked, in response to the question that the sister asked, the asl and the default position is that it's not permissible for the father or the guardian to prevent his daughter from getting married to the right person when he comes about. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says in the Qur'an, وَلَا تَعْضُلُوهُنَّ. Do not prevent them. The word وَلَا تَعْضُلُوهُنَّ, it means if the right person comes for the hand of your daughter, Allah is instructing us as fathers and as guardians not to prevent that girl from the right person. If the father then chooses to be stubborn and prevents the girl from marrying the right person, then in Islam the woman will not be oppressed. The guardianship will swiftly move on to next in power, the person who's closest. And inshallah ta'ala, I will make a detailed series on this, bi'idhnillah, where I will speak about this issue in great details, inshallah ta'ala. Who is the next in kin and who is next in power to take over. But then if she doesn't have any of that, she has no one else to take her responsibility, and this dispute stands, the qadi will marry her off to the person he sees fit for her. A woman is not allowed to marry herself off if there's no problem. She finds a boy that she likes and she wants him, and she's too shy to take him to her father, and so she goes and she marries herself off. This is not allowed in Islam, it's prohibited. It goes against the clear-cut evidences, and it also goes against the view of the great scholars of Islam, such as Malik ibn Anas and Shafi'i and Ahmed. And Imam Abu Hanifa opposed the evidence in this issue. With the respect and love that we have for him, we will choose the evidence over his opinion and his view. Because the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, أَيُّمَ امْرَأَةٍ نَكَحَتْ بِغَيْرِ إِذْنِ وَلِيِّهَا فَنِكَاحُهَا بَاطِلٌ فَنِكَاحُهَا بَاطِلٌ فَنِكَاحُهَا بَاطِلٌ. The Prophet said, any woman who marries herself off without the permission of her guardian, then her marriage is false, is null and void. It has no base to it. Also, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam told us, if he then has sexual intercourse with her, that man, what's the ruling? The Prophet said, فَإِنْ دَخَلَ بِهَا فَالْمَهْرُ لَهَا. If he has sexual intercourse with her in this way, then she still has the right of dowry, this woman. And her dowry will be the dowry of the women of her city and her town. فَإِنْ تَشَاجَرُوا فَالسُّلْطَانُ وَلِيُّ مَنْ لَا وَلِيَ لَهُ. The Prophet then, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, if the woman and her guardian dispute one another, the Prophet said, then the qadi, the judge, will be a wali for the woman who has no wali. He will take over. Now, my beloved brothers and sisters, the marriage in Islam is not what many people understand from it. Yani some people assume going to the town hall and marry yourself off in the UK system, for instance, or the American system, makes it a marriage. In Islam, there is no nikah without the permission of a guardian and two witnesses. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam has said, لَا نِكَاحَ إِلَّا بِوَلِيٍّ وَشَاهِدَيْ عَدْلٍ. There is no nikah, and there's no marriage to a woman unless there is the permission of the guardian and two witnesses. There has to be two witnesses in Islam. And these two witnesses cannot be non-Muslims. There have to be two Muslims who are reliable. Also, in the sister's question, she said, I traveled to another country to get married to this brother. The sister should know that it is not permissible for a woman to travel to another country without her guardian with her, or her mahram. A mahram, it can be her son, it can be her brother, it can be her maternal or her paternal uncle, or also can be her father. All of those people are her mahram, and she has to travel with them. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said لا يحل لامرأة تؤمن بالله واليوم الآخر أن تسافر سفرا يكون ثلاثة أيام فصاعدا إلا ومعها أبوها أو ابنها أو زوجها أو أخوها أو ذو محرم منها. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, it's not permissible for a woman who believes in Allah and believes in the Day of Judgment for her to travel, a traveling of 3 days or more, except that she does it with her father, her brother, her husband, her son, or someone who is her mahram. Now, some other narrations clearly and categorically state that she's not allowed to travel at all, whether it be a minute or two, without a guardian. So the sister has to understand that. And if she did travel without a mahram, without any disputation between her and her guardian, and she just ran and she got married, and what she is saying is not the case, then what the sister needs to remember is that the Prophet ﷺ's statement, فَنِكَاحُهَا بَاطِلٌ فَنِكَاحُهَا بَاطِلٌ فَنِكَاحُهَا بَاطِلٌ, her nikah is null and void. And the qa'ida, according to the scholars and the dhabit, is that كُلُّ مَا يُؤَدَّى إِلَى حَرَامٍ فَهُوَ حَرَامٌ أَمَّا مَا كُلُّ مَا بُنِيَ عَلَى فَاسِدٍ فَهُوَ فَاسِدٌ. First of all, you traveled without a mahram, then you get the sin for it. And that is a means that you took in order to get married. So you built your marriage from the beginning in disobeying Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. And then if your guardian wasn't a problem for you, and you went to the other country, and then you married yourself off, then your nikah is null and void. Your issue needs to be revised by a qadi who can look deeply into the issue. I only gave you an outline. وَالْعِلْمُ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ تَعَالَى, knowledge is with Allah. وَآخِرُ دَعْوَانَا أَنِ الْحَمْدُ لِلَّهِ رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ سبحانك اللهم بحمده أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أستغفرك وأتوب إليه.
If you have any questions you'd like to see answered as part of this series, then you can email us at questions@amau.org.